So in this video we are demonstrating the setup for the ADI. What you see on the right side is a standard 24 volts DC power supply, and to the left of it with the blue block is the power supply that creates with a local oscillator 115 volts AC 400 hertz. And then we come to the setup. I'll zoom in a bit. So the setup of the ADI, it consists of at the bottom to top of a carrier board to make the interconnections. Then you get two SDI boards, the synchro device interface board, and the top one is the ADI support board with some amplifiers, DC-DC converters for all the other required power supply voltages, plus and minus 5 volt, plus and minus 12 volts, and a few relays that activate the ADI. So next to that, we get of course the ADI. I'll put a bit more light on that one. And the interface is connected to the PC with two USB connections. I'll show that for one moment. Here, there we are. And first, let's power up. When the power is applied, you'll see that the off vane disappears. Like that. Now, you hear Windows telling that he has recognized the USB port. So I'll start the test application. There's the test application. And first you have to do is select the COM ports for the pitch SDI and the roll SDI. When that's done, I can enable the flags. Perhaps you heard a click, but now I can move the flags in and out of the view. And I'll put that a bit more that you can see the ADI. So that's the glide slope flag, up, gone. The localizer flag and the aux flag. And when I turn off the enable flag, you'll see that they all appear again or disappear again. Likewise, we have the glide slope. That's the glide slope and localizer bars. Let's first get them completely out of view. This is the maximum value. And that's one. And now the other, an opposite value, and that's gone too. In the bottom you see the rate of turn indicator, that's down here. I can move that completely to the left, like that, or to the right, or any value you like, of course. It's an analog controlled signal. And with mid value, it returns to the center position. And most important of the ADI is, of course, roll and pitch indication. So I enable the roll and pitch synchros. And let's pitch first, get it centered correctly. I think this is the value I need. And this is the other value. Okay, so it's a bit more, perhaps 444. No, the other side, the other opposite side, 422. And now I can rotate, for example, roll in steps of let's say from 512, which it is now, to 514. You'll see a slight movement. There it is. See? And I'll turn back again so that you have an idea of the resolution. Of course, you can make big swings, let's say for a quarter, instantaneously, and you see the complete instrument will shake. And that works. And going down further or completely turned around like this. Or in one swing, back up. Whoop. And the same goes for the pitch indication. Let's go to 499 or 555. I don't know how much the highest value is. See, you can go further, 666. That's almost against the limit. In my ADI, it has a hard stop. So if I try to go further, I think I've limited the maximum value in the software. Yes, indeed, I have. You'll see that it will slam against the end stop. Now, I'll try to avoid that. Back to center, 422 or something like that. Hop. And that's about it. So when I disable the glide slope indicators, you'll see that the command bars immediately return to their center position. Like that. Or if I enable again, back to there, and I can set them at any value, of course, like this, 100 and that. So when I disable everything, everything is basically powerless or disabled inside the ADI. Enable pitch and roll, gone. The glide slope and localizer, gone. And the flex, gone. So and now I turn off the power, and then the off flag will also be visible again. That's it. Bye.